Set on a plateau almost 700 meters above sea level, about 35 kilometers from Enna, the city of Piazza Armerina, a splendid art city, is the heart of Sicily. The city was flourishing during Roman times, which is manifested in some of its architectures, showing Norman or Gothic styles. However, the best of Sicily is hidden somewhere in its rural area, the Villa del Casale. Combining residential and productive functions, Roman villa was a distinctive feature of Roman society. It was an expression not only of a particular lifestyle, but also of a Roman society in general. Villas were emblematic of membership to the upper class. The complex nature of the villas is reflected by the formation of definition given by different people. While in Roman literature, the word describes not only an estate residence built and equipped according to notions of an elegant urban lifestyle, but also the relatively unpretentious form of a comfortable cultivator who owns a medium-sized tract. However, the matter is complicated by the existence in the Roman Empire of leisure homes by the shore or close to some convenient town, which probably had little or no interest in farming. Thus, according to Pliny the Elder, there were two kinds of villas: the Villa Urbana, which was a country seat that could easily be reached from Rome, and the Villa Rustica, the farmhouse estate permanently occupied by its owner. The Roman Empire was at its greatest height between the emperors Augustus and Marcus Aurelius. Under this relatively peaceful period, the empire grew to its greatest extent, guarded by the world's strongest professional army. The increasing trading brings large amounts of commodities, and the building of aqueducts brings fresh water. The city of Rome had grown in size, complexity, and wealth, while rustic villas continued to dominate the rural economic life by providing markets, employment, and industries, such as cloth-making, wine, and olive presses, and specialty shops. The late empire's economic history indicates a movement from a unified market economy to regional markets. This occurred mainly due to the political and military events, and resulted in regional chauvinism and unrest. In particular, a rise in the number of isolated and fortified villas draws people-built village around them. The Roman exploitation of the countryside is symbolized by the Villa Romana del Casale, which is especially noteworthy for the richness and quality of the mosaics, which decorate almost every room. They are the finest mosaics in good situation anywhere in the Roman world. Although its real owner is unclear, Marcus Aurelius Maximinianus, a Pannonian who had risen from the ranks of the Roman army to become a general, and then was raised to the status of Augustus by Diocletian, is generally thought to own the villa because of its luxurious decoration. This building, which merits the title of palace rather than villa, is designed in the tradition of the Roman villa, but on a scale and to a level of luxury with no parallels in the Roman Empire. The villa has served several purposes. It contains some rooms that were clearly residential, others that clearly had representative purposes, a number of rooms whose intended use cannot be discerned today. According to those excavated rooms, we can assume that the villa is probably used as a permanent or semi-permanent residence for its owner. As a reference to the tragic house in Pompeii, it is easy to imagine the owner, in his role as a patron or some nobles from royal families, receives his clients or friends in the villa. On the other hand, as the villa is the center of the village, we can also assume it serves administrative purpose. The main entrance led into a courtyard, which provided access to the large peristyle, which looked overlooked by guest rooms and the owner's private apartments. Beyond the guest rooms were the servants' quarters, complete with kitchen. The family's private apartments were divided into two by a large public hall for meetings and official receptions. In the living area, consisting of a large elliptical atrium which gave onto a large dining room, six small rooms and service amenities, was situated to the south of the complex. The western part of the complex housed the baths. The water was supplied by two aqueducts connected to a third, which in turn was fed by the river Gela, flowing a few meters away. What makes the villa unique are its floors, mainly consisting of mosaics, fortunately survived in excellent condition. The majority of panels feature a wide range of subjects: mythological scenes, incidents from daily life, special occasions, a great hunt, circus games, feast days honoring the gods, and a grape harvest. The rare skill with which the wild and exotic animals have been portrayed has been interpreted as the work of North African craftsmen. Each room has a theme. The Frigidarium, a room set aside for cold baths, has a fine central mosaic with a marine theme, consisting of fishermen surrounded by dolphins and fish. A place far from the sea, only people with high status could afford seafood. The fish are depicted as being caught and prepared for cooking. Serving fish for dinner was a kind of showing off, so the way the fishing scene is presented on the floor is to flaunt the owner's power and wealth. In the corridor of the Great Hunt, Rome's fascination of wild animals and exotic beasts was shown by the activities in the arena. The room, 60 meters long with a recess at each end, is the most pleasant and monumental part of the whole villa. The floor mosaic depicts an incredibly elaborate hunting scene. Panthers, lions, wild boar, elephants, hippopotamus, and rhinoceros are captured and put into cages to be loaded onto ships destined for Rome. What makes this composition so extraordinary is the great variety of its scenes. The realism with which men are shown vying with wild beasts, the strong scene of action and movement, the wealth of articulation, and attention to detail. Note, for example, how the limbs of animals shown underwater are portrayed in a different color to the parts above the surface. Further on, another scene shows the same extreme sophistication in detail. A tiger pounces on a crystal ball in which an image of the animal is reflected. Hunting was a favorite pastime of Rome's nobility, which is manifested by the main theme of the mosaics in the whole villa. The room of the small hunt, just down the hall, preserves panels depicting the most important moments in the heat of the hunt. In order to give thanks for favorable conditions and a successful day, a sacrifice is offered to Diana, the goddess of hunting, a figure of whom is on a high column in the middle ground. Two high-ranking officials burn incense on the altar, while, behind them, a wild boar is brought forth in a net, and another hunter holds up a hare that he has caught. Below the sacrifice scene, a banquet is represented, at which the participants rest on a stabadium around a table with a large bird. The whole of the central part of the mosaic is dominated by the banqueting scene. Shaded by a red awning slung between the trees, game is being cooked over a fire. Che mai più grande esisterà. The room of the 10 girls has a mosaic showing two rows of girls dressed in bikini. In fact, they are pictured in their underwear, which was also commonly used to practice gymnastics. The young women concentrate on performing their various exercises: jumping, disc throwing, racing, and ball games. In the bottom row, a girl wearing a toga is about to award another girl the palm of victory, who has been performing exercises with a hoop, trundling it with the aid of a stick. The mosaics are the glory of the Villa del Casale. On stylistic grounds, it is believed that at least two master mosaicists worked on the villa, one working in a more classical style on principally mythological scenes, and the other using a more realistic approach for scenes of contemporary life. As it is now, the mosaics throughout the Villa del Casale make up the largest collection of Roman mosaics anywhere. It has also landed the villa on UNESCO's list of World Heritage Sites to instruct and to enlighten. È un grande amore, e mai più grande esisterà.